Magic friends, welcome to Magic Mondays, episode 1. My name is Paul, and thank you so much for watching. It truly does mean a lot to me, as does Magic, which I think you'll find out very soon. So the point of Magic Mondays is to give back to you, the Magic community. I'm so grateful for the resources and fellow magicians that have helped me along the way. I think it's only right that I give back, and part of giving back is literally giving. I'm excited that we're going to be giving away some awesome tricks, books, DVDs. 100 subscribers will be giving away some cool stuff. And we also have contests on our Facebook and Instagram, just as a way of saying thank you for supporting. Damn. So as I'm developing my new shows and close-up routines, I decided that I wanted a torn and restored card. So I've been playing with 5 of them, and I'm going to give you my opinion on those, but please keep in mind, what works for me may not work for you. We all have different presentational styles. I think that's important to note. So the first one is Torn by Daniel Garcia. I had fun playing around with it, and I love how the back is signed. I think it adds some credibility to the restoration. But compared to some of the other ones, it's just not as visual, also not as clean as I would like it to be. So it's probably not going to be my go-to. In terms of signed, I absolutely love Brent Braun's Torched and Restored. Insanely visual. Again, it's signed, and it's flashy. Now, you're not necessarily left clean, but what I like about this one is that the restoration is so powerful and so bright that you have all of the misdirection in the world to then do what you have to do. And I've been doing this for a while, and I'm definitely going to keep this one in my arsenal. The next one is TNR by Matthew Biche. I was about to show you the gimmick. That would have been bad. I felt like a little kid making this gimmick, and also performing it in front of a mirror just blew me away. It does look insanely magical. The trick aspect is also a bonus. So besides the restoration, you have a card revelation. If I were to do a torn and restored card for television, I would do TNR by Matthew Biche. My main problem with it is just how it leaves you. I don't like having a magic moment and then having to do a move. I would much rather do a move and then have a magic moment just because of how it leaves you. It leaves you in a much better position. But I'm going to keep playing around with it. It's a lot of fun. I would recommend it. My go-to torn and restored effect has to be Wayne Houchin's Counterfeit. Oh, I'm in love. Now, this is the most workable for my style of performing. The piece-by-piece restoration is almost as believable to me while I'm performing it, which I love. Now, this may take a few decks of practice, but once you get it, it is super visual. Not only that, but after the first restoration, you can then have them touch the card. To me, that just takes it to a whole nother level, especially with their involvement, but also the believability in that it was actually torn and now it's put back on. You'll need a little bit of confidence to perform a certain move, but that will come with performing it and also practicing it, which this deserves. And last but certainly not least is Blake Voigt's Reform. In a pinch with what this has to offer, it's hard to beat. There are no duplicates, it can be signed, it's impromptu, there's only one card, and I love the idea. What I don't like is how you're left with a torn card in the end, but for an impromptu torn and restored card effect, I think it's worth it, and it's worth practicing and performing. So a little XCM for you nerds out there. So before we go, I'd like to give you a shout out to my main man, my dude, my boy, Nicholas Einhorn. One of the first magic books that I ever received. Stole from a library, bought from a library. And it brings me to the segue of next week. Magic books. Before we go, next week I will be reviewing some books. One that I'm very excited about, Darren Brown's Pure Effect. I already started reading it. I'm getting a ton of value out of it already. We'll also be reviewing some other mentalism effects, which I'm excited about. So check out next Monday. Go ahead and subscribe because we'll be giving away some cool stuff. Every 100 subscribers will have a contest. Also, Instagram and Facebook will have some contests there as well. And that's at Ever Conjuring. So thanks for watching and peace.